Okay, so I've got the Corolla oil filter housing off. This is the original one, which in my other video I thought you could see the flutes getting around it a bit from using it so many times. It's just a plastic piece, so finally got it off. Had to use the floor jack to crank the ratchet, and it finally gave in, so I probably torqued it down a bit too tight. I took it off when the engine was completely cold, so I don't know if that helped make a difference or not. But you could see the marks on the plastic housing where the flute grips around the filter wrench. So that's the part that was slipping. Looks like it's on this one side here. The other sides don't look too bad. If you compare it to the new one, I'm not sure how well you could see, but you could maybe tell the difference between the brand new one on the right and the old one on the left to see how much it's wearing. So I have two now. One's going to be a backup in case I crack one of them, which it hasn't yet, so I doubt that's going to happen. You might be able to see some of the scoring here like this on the bottom here, but that's how it looks. Let's try test fitting the oil filter wrench just to see if there's any difference in play. So there's the oil filter wrench. You know, it fits on good, but you know, the tiny little play is what causes it to slip, so you can't really probably hear the difference, but it's a little bit of a, quite loose. I can just pop it on and off, no problem. On the new one, yeah, it's even just tougher just getting it on with one hand, just because the corners are grabbing. So there we go. It's about the same, maybe, but just because I think it's probably grabbing better inside, that's just going to make the difference. So from now on, I'll make sure I don't over tighten it. They say better tighter than necessary to be safe, but in this case, you probably want to think twice and, you know, don't over tighten it. Leave it for a bit, see if it seeps oil past the O-ring that goes on the filter housing. I mean, you subjectively feel it's too loose, but it's not leaking. It's probably better that way. Just check it a couple times after doing your oil change, and that way it should never get stuck on here. So we'll see how this new one goes. I might just use the old one and just make sure I don't over torque it, and now I know how to get it off different ways. You know, it's not cracked or anything, so I might just use the old one again. It's still in okay shape. Anyways, that's it.